Sí ayuda.
Bastante, ¿verdad? Sí. Necesita uno de esos en su casa.
Sí. Ok, ahora sí.
Ahora sí.
Y a ver, ¿cuántos años tiene con esta panadería?
Tenemos 11 años.
Ok.
11 años ya aquí en esta localidad.
So, entonces vino a Las Vegas, ¿por qué? ¿Porque pensó que aquí había oportunidad o qué?
Pues sí, buscando más, mejores, mejor empleo, mejor trabajo. Uh-huh. Es que en realidad yo de donde venía se inundó la ciudad y tuvimos que salir porque ya no había trabajo. O sea, casi la
casa. ¿Cuál ciudad?
La ciudad de Irapuato. Irapuato, bueno.
Ah, en México. Okay.
En el tiempo en que yo salí de allá. Y entonces, como buscando trabajo, llegué hasta acá.
Ajá.
Y aquí me quedé.
¿Cómo le ocurrió la idea de, pues, de poner su propio negocio? Porque eso es un poco
estresante.
Sí.
Sí, arriesgado.
Sí, no todo el mundo se quiere arriesgar de esa forma.
Bueno, en realidad que fueron bastantes años los que trabajé para el casino, que ya para la edad que tenía, decía, muy pronto, ya también por la edad no le dan trabajo a uno en otras partes. Entonces traté de tener la palabra.
Y ¿cuáles opiniones tienes sobre la reforma migratoria? ¿Ha escuchado lo que está pasando con ese debate sobre ese tema? Y
oh, sí, como no, es importante. Digo, todavía yo tengo familia que necesita que pase la reforma migratoria para poder estabilizar su estatus. Es importante, yo creo que para la comunidad de nosotros es importante que pase, porque tanto es beneficioso para nuestra comunidad como para los Estados Unidos en realidad. Uh-huh. Pero hay tantas opiniones diferentes que la gente a veces está mal informada y piensa que es una mala ley que se va a pasar si nos ayudan a nosotros, pero nosotros no creo que lo somos, nosotros contribuimos a este país.
No, pues sí, solo.
Y yo creo que es, como minoría estamos siendo vistos un poquito más porque hemos salido ya más a las calles, ya hay más gente que se está haciendo ciudadanos y que tiene un poquito más de voto, más de visualidad para el futuro de los niños, porque en realidad es lo que nos importa. Y si nosotros no nos unimos, no va a haber ayuda para nuestros niños, para nuestros hijos. Bueno, la estabilidad de nuestra gente está en la seguridad.
Sí.
En la seguridad familiar. Si tienen un poco de dinero que invertir, no lo van a invertir si no tienen la seguridad.
Ajá, sí.
Entonces, en los negocios latinos van a crecer si nuestra gente tiene la seguridad necesaria.
Sí.
Porque no pueden invertir, no pueden comprar casas, no pueden hacer muchas cosas que no pueden hacer.
Sí.
Si en realidad no tienen la estabilidad.
Sí. Okay. ¿Y qué hace esto?
Esto es para que se pongan, para hacerlo más moisto.
Oh, ok, alright. ¿Y es como qué? ¿Como azúcar?
Ajá, azúcar. Es un
simple. Es el simple syrup.
Ok, simple syrup. Uh-huh. ¿Y usted cuánto tiempo tiene haciendo pasteles? Sí.
Uy. Empecé a hacer pasteles desde los 11 años.
¿De los 11 años? ¿Es dónde?
Tengo 34 en México.
Wow, ok. ¿De dónde viene México?
De Tecate, Guadalajara.
Ok. ¿Y cuánto tiempo tiene aquí en Las Vegas?
Aquí tengo 10 años, 9 años y medio.
Ajá.
De los cuales 8 trabajando.
Y cortando los pasteles así.
Pero yo creo que la reforma migratoria es importante. No tanto que nos beneficie lo personal, como en mi persona, digo yo, que si yo tengo aquí a mi mamá y a mi papá, gracias a que yo también me hice ciudadano y que lo pude
traer. Bueno.
Pero
y vota,
pero sí, desde luego que sí, desde luego que sí. Si no se hace, si uno se hace ciudadano y no vota, entonces no hay razón para hacerse ciudadano. Porque debemos de hacerlo notar de esa manera. Pero yo creo que en realidad para nuestra comunidad es importante por la separación de familias. Es una cosa que nosotros debemos de luchar por eso.
Sí.
Porque si no nos perjudica personal, perjudica todo. Porque los niños que se quedan aquí solos están mal cuidados. Y esos niños crecen con pues probablemente que la mitad de ellos estén bien, pero la mitad de ellos van a estar mal. Y viene la comunidad en donde cambia nuestra manera de ser, de pensar, y son el futuro de nosotros. Si los niños es el futuro de nosotros, si no ponemos atención a eso, entonces dice, pues estoy bien yo, pero no, no, nuestra comunidad es importante en general.
Seal material, you're ready to go.
Oh yeah. This, well, I remember when I opened this store, I have a savings, and my business in Los Angeles was so small compared to this one. So I have, you know, approximately about $50,000 in savings, and plus my inventory was not that much. When I opened this store, I thought sure it was gonna be full. Believe me, I was not even one quarter of a store with that money.
The savings couldn't fry that much furniture
I was in shock. Yeah. I remember one of the suppliers that came, one of the salesmen from the factory, and they came and asked me, when is your grand opening? When are you going to get the rest of the furniture? And I said, it is open. The door's open. That's all I can afford it. I said, you opened? I said, yes. I have a scatter all over a few things. I said, that's all I can afford it. I thought it was going to be enough money, but God is going to help me get this full. I stopped working 7 days a week. This store, 5 years ago or later, or before that, it was like a museum. Really nice furniture.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, this is nothing compared to where it used to be. And I don't bring that much. This kind of furniture used to be, and now the way the economy is, nobody can afford it now. The one that slowed down quite a bit is Spanish population.
Yes.
Right. Yeah, those are the ones that really makes a difference on it, on the economy. So.
Well, I think that, and as you were pointing out, that's just one of the ways that improving our immigration system and improving the flow of incoming people, making it easier to become a citizen eventually. All of that will make the economy better, as well as just have a better, more fair immigration system. So we need to find ways to get that word out, and I think your explanation is as good as any we'll ever get.
This is something that is, I hope they pass the bill and immigration reform that really, I think that's the key of the whole economy.
Yes.
I remember when the last immigration passed many years ago, the economy was the greatest.
The current administration has been quite consistently in favor of a liberal approach to immigration. Let people in, let them move on with their lives and progress, earn good money. So I think we're all of us kind of hoping that
if it passes this bill,
we'll be able to get the bill through the Congress.
If it passes this bill, the economy and the whole country, they're going to be really tremendous impact. But once they legalize it, then they can go ahead and start see those taxpayers, and they're going to see their country, the changes on the whole. How the important is to the Spanish community. Mm-hmm. I mean, we're talking about 11 million people. That's a lot. So why is it important to get this go through?
Yeah, I think a lot of the people who are holding back and not wanting to approve the kind of immigration reform we need, they're focused on an idea that they have that's mostly wrong, that people are flooding in and taking advantage of our economy, taking advantage of the people who are here. It's almost exactly the opposite. They're coming in and becoming workers, earning incomes, paying taxes. They're becoming like the rest of us, just as soon as they can get here and you know, and get citizenship and so on. So
all they need, that's why it's so important to get this bill passed, because it's a lot of people up there waiting for and able to become a good citizen, a good taxpayer. And that's why it's so important to pass this bill, and I'm looking forward to do whatever it takes to to contribute. But,
and I think your history and this store together really illustrate to for anyone who will look and inquire that this is the way it works. And it works well if all the participants are contributing and helping and teaching the youngsters as they come in and helping them learn, reminding them how hard they have to work, how long they have to work. But that's worked, you know, historically throughout this country in every line of business, I think. So this is about as splendid an example as I've ever seen. Very, very proud to know you, and I want to thank you for everything you've done.
Thank you, sir.
For the community. Pleasure.
I came to Las Vegas 1 year ago and tried to find a job, but it was impossible. I applied everywhere, and I didn't have the opportunity. This is the way I find
others do.
Others, yeah.
And that is part of the problem, because you're a skilled worker as well. You know, because you have background in banking
experience.
And so it's actually in the economy right now. That's the hardest group to find employment. So when you couldn't find employment,
could find my husband. I said, I need to find a job. What are you going to do? We started looking for a business,
right.
And it was very, very great opportunity because, first of all, the location.
Right.
There's a lot of Spanish people, and I feel like, oh my God, I can work with the Spanish people, and I had experience 21 years working with customer service, and I had a month working at this store. Ashley is our manager for me, like 1 year.
Yeah.
And she tried very hard to take care of customers in Spanish,
right.
And she doesn't speak Spanish, and she
can understand.
Good job.
But yeah, you're like me.
I
can somewhat understand it, but yeah, wanting to be able to engage people, especially if they have a problem, because a lot of times you find in these smaller UPS, actually, I've found the post offices. It's how do I get money to my family? There's other issues that come up other than
I'm
just
me. I'm so, so happy because I can help a lot of Spanish people about to paperwork and help with anything.
Mm-hmm.
And we try so hard to the people can take care of paperwork,
right.
Legal paperwork and everything. And I think it's great. It's
so
great.
You become a resource to them other than just the mail. And
yes.
Maybe that's something
very absolutely. We try to do
unique
everything. And I take care. For me, this, the most important is help my people,
mm-hmm.
and help everybody. And I feel very, very lucky to be part of the United States, to this country. And I think it's fair that everybody had the same opportunities,
right.
To work, to have,
raise
like,
their family.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
She has
too,
two
so.
three children.
Over,
beautiful,
yeah.
Beautiful.
Do you really?
Yeah.
Oh, you're so young, both of you. But that is part of what you're trying to build, is something for your kids, to make sure that they're well-educated, that they have opportunities the same as anybody else.
Exactly.
What were their difficulties trying to buy a business, get loans for a business? What did you run into that might be a little bit different from me, who's, you know, Caucasian?
You know, it's I feel great because my husband support me and everything. And,
right.
But I think the language communicated is very hard.
Mm-hmm.
When you try the, in my case, it was very good because I had opportunity to, the bank let
right.
me loan the money and everything. But I think we need more help.
Mm-hmm.
We need more help.
Well, Mike and
we
I
need more information.
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 Workshops on how small business can maybe get advantage of different things that I might not even know about.
It's true. Uh-huh.
Mike, your accountant, was just telling me that, you know, trying to find out what loans are available for women or minorities is very difficult as well. So I will help with that part of it. But that is, some people wouldn't even know to ask.
Some,
that's
exactly.
The sad
this is
part.
Where we need more communication. We need more communication with information.
Right.
I'm sorry. We need more information about all these type opportunities, like people can grow and have
right.
a better life, better possibilities to run a business,
right.
to do different things, and help the economically to this country.
Yes.
Because everybody, I believe the Spanish community work very hard, and
very.
We know everybody knows that.
Yes.
And we need support.
Yes.
We need.
But there are still communities, so people that judge, well, they don't speak English.
And it's very hard.
It's
I have been in the United States for 13 years. My husband is American. My right. children speak perfect English. My neighbors, my friends. And it's hard for me to speak English. And I had a lot of mistakes. And I tried to say, okay, I have to speak English no matter what. I hope the people can understand me, but it's very hard. And I understand everybody supposed to speak English, and but you know, it's sometimes it's impossible. I try with my parents. My parents, they live in the United States. They try.
Right.
But if it's difficult for me, you know,
it's very
what happened
hard,
for my parents.
But I watch children helping mom and dad translate.
Yeah.
It's a wonderful
they
program.
Come here.
We do it, yeah.
They
yeah. come here with us. We get a lot of people that have their own business in here mm-hmm. that wants to help with like accounting or bookkeeping, and they want us to do like things on Word or Excel, which we can do.
Right.
But it's a little bit difficult when you don't really have a lot of experience
exactly.
in it. And so when they want to learn it themselves, we don't have nowhere to refer them to. We
perfect.
Try to help them. You know, we'll try to do it on
I'll
Word or Excel.
Well, thank you.
And we feel happy, like Spanish community, that you guys take care in our community and all the immigrants is very, very important.
It is, and this is a unique shopping center.
Yeah.
I've been coming here, actually, this business has been here close to 20 years, and I probably
yes.
have come here for 20 years. So,
I'm very happy.
We have a great neighborhood. We try to support all of our local businesses more than anything, and rather than going to the chains and all the big places that people can't
buy. And you know, my dream is maybe have many plasmeos in all
right.
the city.
Yeah.
This is what I want. It's our goal, actually, right?
This is one type of business that won't go away.
No.
I mean,
no
matter what.
Exactly.
People still have to communicate across boundaries.
You have
so,
everybody,
you know.
And everybody love the store. And everybody, they come for one stamp,
mm-hmm.
for one copy.
One copy, yeah.
For use the computer because some families doesn't
don't
have computer.
Even a lot of the kids
have
now.
Internet then?
Yeah,
yes,
a lot of the kids now
internet.
Have to get their homework offline.
Now we print
yeah,
it for
yesterday
them.
Yesterday we had a lady come in and her son, and you know, he had to get his homework offline and they couldn't do it because they don't have
wow.
internet access. So we're just like, why are they giving you guys homework offline? Yeah. That's what I was asking. Do
we're
we
happy they
have it.
Don't
know,
yeah. We
don't
have any problem to help.
We just
right.
told her next time, call us.
Call ahead
it out.
And you can, yeah.
Yeah, and we'll just have it here waiting for you.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
What a wonderful resource. That's great. Well, thank you for letting me share.
No, thank you so much. We are
and
so happy.
I will
they
be back in
us.
Touch. Mike has given me a job to do.
Okay.
Yes,
so,
please. Thank
and
you.
And I will work on
and
that.
Bien, Rubén, mira, pues mucho gusto. Soy Luisa Cortés. Mi apellido de soltera es González. Uh-huh. Pero cuando llegué a Estados Unidos me dijeron, tienes que adoptar el apellido de tu esposo. Entonces, por eso aquí yo soy Luisa Cortés González. Llegué hace 25 años a este país. Llegué a California buscando tal vez completar un sueño que yo tenía. Mi esposo y yo somos personas que en México tenemos nuestras carreras. Mi esposo es ingeniero pesquero. Yo soy trabajadora social titulado, los dos. Mi esposo dijo, voy por un año para yo regresar y buscar una oportunidad aquí en México. Tú sabes que en México no se dan las oportunidades tan fácil. Mi esposo se tuvo que quedar más tiempo y pasado como un año, tuve que venir para saber qué estaba pasando, si se iba a regresar. A mí me interesaba que se regresara al país, porque yo ya estaba trabajando. Pero cuando yo llego aquí y veo que él ya está trabajando y que no se quiere ir porque él ya está ganando, lo que hacemos muchas personas que llegamos a este país. Uh-huh. Llegamos, se nos olvida o nos da miedo regresar a nuestro país porque sabemos que no hay tantas oportunidades. Y que si yo ya estoy ganando, no me puedo regresar. ¿Por qué? Porque probablemente no tenga la oportunidad de volver y probablemente en nuestro país ya no haya la oportunidad de trabajar. Bueno, pues mira, pues te presento el negocio. Nosotros hacemos aquí quinceañeras, bodas, bautizos, baby shower. Y nos destaca a nosotros este negocio porque nosotros aquí hacemos nuestros propios diseños y nosotros los elaboramos.
¿Y cuánto tiempo llevan en el negocio? abierto?
Tenemos 11 años ya, luchando mucho. Empezamos, estaba la economía buena, luego se nos vino abajo la economía y nosotros pensamos sostenernos y no hacer el efecto dominó. Nosotros siempre estamos a las 10 de la mañana y la tienda se cierra a las 7, pero nos tenemos que quedar a terminar los trabajos a veces hasta las 9, 10 de la noche.
Sí, me imagino.
Todos tenemos ahorita ese problema que trabajamos más y ganamos menos. Pero hay que salir, porque el país necesita de estos brazos ahorita. Así es.
Y señora, usted, y ahora con lo del debate de la reforma de migración y todo eso, ¿cómo cree que es tan importante de que se pase esta reforma?
Mire, es tan importante porque yo a todas las personas que están en el negocio de cualquier tipo de negocio, les digo, es tan importante la reforma migratoria porque si no pasa la reforma migratoria no se levanta el país. Tenemos familias que no gastan un 5 porque están ahorrando por si viene la reforma, poder pagar lo de sus papeles.
Sí.
Entonces nosotros vemos cómo pasan y pasan el tiempo y no se aprueba la reforma y nosotros estamos sin clientes. Entonces yo pienso que...
O sea que sería un estímulo a la economía y particularmente para su negocio si estas personas son legalizadas y ahora empiezan a gastar dinero.
Bastante grande.
Porque mucho ese dinero que han estado acumulando, ahorrando, lo tienen,
pero
no lo quieren gastar.
Pero no lo quieren gastar porque tengo amigas que son... 4 o 5 personas en una sola familia y ellas dicen es que no podemos hacer nada ahorita porque no sabemos si va a pasar la reforma. Entonces mientras esté estancado todo lo de la reforma, 11 millones están sin gastar. Cuidado con el
resistor,
le pone aquí, cuidado con sus dedos.
Más tantito,
póngale un poco más porque si no se nos va a caer ahí. Ahora lo va a poner por la cara de aquí.
¿Aquí?
Abajo.
¿Más?
Ahí.
Y tenemos nuestra copita.
Ahora le vamos a cortar. Y mire, le voy a hacer el secreto. Póngale spray ahí, así. Del pelo, simple spray del pelo. Ahora le póngale este brillo como salecita.
Ah, mira nomás.
¿Qué le pareció?
Qué bonito. Y esto es hairspray.
Es spray de pelo. Esto hay un spray especial para pegar el glue, pero si nosotros lo usamos, es como lo usamos diario, nos puede dañar los pulmones.
Y está aquí, ya está listo.
¡Ey! ¡Qué presentación hiciste!
Ya estoy listo para venderlo.
Ya.